So today we are starting our new exercise 7F. Okay, here question number 1 we'll start. Question number 1A. Just see in your textbook. Number A is how much longer is Papa's belt? Here they have shown you belt of Papa and the son also. Both the belt are shown. And even that meter scale is given in between, and that is 1 meter. Okay. Just compare. Just see Papa's belt is 8. If you will count this part, no, they are 8 sections. So out of 10, 8. So 8 upon 10 meter is Papa's belt. And the son's belt is 6 upon 10 meter. Okay. We have to find the difference, how much longer it is. So 8 upon 10 minus 6 upon 10 means 8 minus 6 upon 10 is equal to 2 upon 10. So here you will write 2 upon 10 meter. Right. This way you have to do. Okay. Question number 2 is find the difference. First one has been done. Here two sums are given. One is already done for you and number B I am explaining you. Just see here what you have to do. First count the total number of circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the denominator will be 12. Okay. Now you have what you have to do. Now you have to see the shaded part. How much is shaded? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 upon 12 are shaded part. Okay. And now what you will see? How much shaded part is crossed? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So out of 12, 4 part is cancelled, right? So 7 upon 12 minus 4 upon 12 is equal to, you have to find the answer now. 12 will remain 12. Don't do 12 minus 12, it will become 0, okay? So you have to write 12 as it is. No addition or no subtraction in the denominators. 7 minus 4, if you count, it will be 3 upon 12. So that is the fraction of question number 2B, right? Now question number 3, subtract. Here two different sums I am explaining. So I think 12 sums are given in the textbook, but I will explain you two sums. In that, number A, 7 upon 9 minus 1 upon 9. Again student, what you have to do, first write the denominator. Once again I am reminding you, don't write 9 minus 9, it will become 0, then your sum will be wrong. Write the denominator as it is for one time. And now compare to numerator. Now you have to see numerator. Numerator is 7 minus 1, right? So 7 minus 1 will become 6 upon 9. So this is your fraction. 6 upon 9 is your answer. Okay. Now number K. Student, here they have given you 1 minus 1 upon 5. So might be you get confused by seeing 1, that no fraction is given. How you will do? How you will subtract? So let me remind you. 1 means what? 1 is whole. Okay, just see here, I am comparing it by showing you the drawing. Imagine that this is a pizza and this is the whole pizza. Okay, two same size of pizza drawn here. Okay, now here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. See, 5 equal parts I have made of pizza, right? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So from that, this is 1. Okay, this one. So can I say this is 1 upon 5? Yes, we can say 1 upon 5. Once again, I am drawing 5 equal parts. Okay, but here I am shading all parts. Okay, so can I say it is 5 upon 5 or I can say it is 1? Yes. Means all part means 1. 5 out of 5 parts means 1 whole. So instead of 1, whenever such type of thing is given, whatever is there on the other part, denominator 5, both that number will come in numerator and denominator both. Because 1 whole means total number of parts, whatever is there in the next fraction, here it is 5. So out of 5 parts, all the 5 parts are being included. Okay, so 5 upon 5, instead of 1, you will write here 5 upon 5 minus 1 upon 5. Now students, you have both the fractions. So same method you will again write. Do here denominator will remain 1 only, means 5 only. And now 5 minus 1 is equal to 4 upon 5. This is your answer. Right? This way, whenever 1 is given, then you have to see the other fraction. In other fraction, whatever denominator is given, the same number you have to write in numerator and denominator. Why you have to write, do like that? That I have explained you by showing this example. Okay, fine. I hope you have understood. And so we'll start the new exercise, application in real life. Here three sums are given to you. From that, number A, Hari drank 8 upon 11 of glass of buttermilk, and Sundar drank 9/11 of a glass of buttermilk. Who drank more and how much more did he drink? See, Hari drank 8/11 and Sundar drank 9/11. Now, which number will come first? For that, you should know which is the bigger number. Always write the bigger number before. Okay. So, 9/11 is the fraction which is bigger than 8/11. So, that will come first and put the subtraction sign in between. And then 9 - 8/11 is equal to 1/11. Okay. Now, here you have to write the answer in statement. Who drank more? Obviously, Sundar drank more. How much more he drank? Sundar drank 1/11 glass of buttermilk more than Hari. Right? This is the answer in statement which you have to write. Now, number B, that is Kabir drank 5/6 of a glass of milk in the morning and 3/6 of a glass of milk in the evening. 5/6 of glass of milk in the morning and 3/6 in the evening. How much more did he drink in the morning? Means in morning, how much more he has drank? So 5/6 - 3/6 is equal to 5 - 3/6. You'll get your answer 2/6, and then you have to write the answer in statement that Kapil drank 2/6 glass of milk more in the morning. Right? Okay, let us move to question number C now. The fruit salad recipe needs 1/5 kg apples and 3/5 kg of grapes. Here, student, you can also read like this way. You can also use the fraction. See, I'm speaking 3/5, 1/5 instead of 3/5, 1/5. Okay. The fruit salad recipe needs 1/5 kg of apples and 3/5 kg of grapes. Which fruit is required in greater amount and by how much? Again, we will keep 3/5 in first and then subtract it. 3 - 1/5 is equal to 2/5. Okay. Now, this fraction we have found, but the answer which you have to write in statement, which fruit is required in greater amount? Obviously, it is grapes. Grapes are required in greater amount. How much? 2/5 kg. So, answer you will write that 2/5 kg of grapes are required in more amount. Right? This way you have to write the answer of number C. Here we are ending with our exercise 7F. And in our next video, I will continue with the next exercise. Till then, goodbye everyone.